Hi, this is Venkat Narayana from Sunya Technologies. Today I am going to discuss convert string to number in C#. This is continuation to previous video, part 16, user defined conversions in C#. Please go through previous video before going to this video. We can convert string to number in three ways. One is using parse method, second using try parse method, third using convert class. We will discuss parse and try parse in this video. And we will discuss convert class in the next video. We'll discuss parse and try parse concept using Visual Studio. Launch Visual Studio and create C# application. We'll get string value from command prompt console.write, enter I value, declare a variable int I equal to console.readline. Here we are getting error, cannot implicitly convert type string to int. That means here readline method returning string, but we are trying to store it in integer, so we are getting error. We need to convert string to integer. We'll use parse method. Here int32.parse of console.readline. Now we don't have any compile time error, print the output console.write I. If you put cursor on parse method, here we may get three types of exceptions. One is argument null exception, format exception, overflow exception. We'll see these exceptions after a few minutes. Here we are converting string to integer using parse method. We have one more method, try parse method. Now we'll use try parse method to convert string to integer. Read the input from command prompt console.write. Enter j value string j equal to console.readline. Here readline method returning string, we are trying to store it in string, so we don't have an issue. Here we use try parse method int32.tryparse. Try parse method taking two parameters, one is string, another one is out int. So we'll pass string value. Here we have string variable j comma. Now we need to declare out variable to store result out int result. Out is the keyword, so we'll declare out keyword before variable. This variable will be used to store the output. If we put cursor on try parse method, this method taking two parameters, one is string and out int, and returning boolean value. That means if the conversion is succeeded, then it will return true. If conversion fails, it will return false. Here a telling like returns true if s was converted successfully, otherwise false. So this method is returning boolean value. We need to check it in if condition. If console.writeline result, here else console.writeline int32.tryparse could not parse. Here j to int. Now we'll execute this program. We'll put breakpoint here. Put breakpoint here. Go to debug. Click on start debugging or F5. Later click step into or F11. Click on start debugging. Debugging started. F11. We need to provide input in command prompt. Here 1, 2. Enter. Here we provide 12. 12 is a string, so we need to convert string to integer. Here string 12 converted to integer and print the output. We don't have an issue. Here printed F11. Will provide second value here 123. Enter. J is equal to 123. it's in double quotation, that means string. Here we declared result variable, that is out variable, that means this result will store output. And try parse method returning true or false, F11. Here try parse method converted string to integer successfully, so this value is true, so it goes inside. We print the output. Output is 123. Here what is happening, we provided 12 to the parse method, so it will convert from string to integer successfully. Later we provide 123 to try parse method. Try parse method converted string to integer successfully. We don't have an issue and we print the output. We'll stop debugging. I will execute this program in debug mode one more time. Go to debug, click on start debugging, F11, provide input. Here now I will provide input as ABC, enter. Here we are getting error like input string was not in correct format. That means here we pass ABC to the parse method. This parse method unable to convert ABC to integer. So we get the runtime error. So what we need to do, if you want to handle this exception, we need to put this code in try catch block. Here try, copy this code, control X and paste here, catch format exception E, console.writeline E dot message. Now I'll execute this code, put breakpoint here and here, go to debug, click on start debugging, F11, enter I value. I value is A, B, C. This is a string value. We are trying to convert string to integer. CLR will unable to convert string to integer. This is incorrect format. Enter. Here we are getting exception. F11 e.message. e.message is input string was not in correct format. F11 enter. We are entering J value. Here A, B, C. Enter. Here J is ABC and will store result in result variable. And try parse method returning true or false. Here try parse method unable to convert string to integer, that means it will return false. F11 here. Now we are printing else part, int 32 try parse could not parse J into int. Here int 32.try parse could not parse ABC to int. Here what we understood based on parse method and try parse method. Parse method and try parse method will be used to convert string to integer. If you provide correct input, then parse method will convert string to integer without any issue. But if you provide wrong format input to parse method, then it will raise runtime exception. So that is format exception. If you pass input to try parse method, if the input is wrong format, then try parse method returns false and will print error message like int32.tryParse could not parse input to integer. So conclusion is, if you know input is correct format, then use the parse method. If you don't know input is correct format or not, then use tryParse method. TryParse method will return boolean value if it converts string to integer successfully. If it's not converts, it will return false. We'll remove these breakpoints. Control Shift F9. Do you want to delete all breakpoints? Yes, delete it. Here we are converting string to integer, so we need to mention int32.parse method. For example, if you want to convert to double, here I'll mention as a double. If you want to convert string to double, then here mention as double. If you want to convert string to float, here float, then you need to mention like float dot parse method. So parse and try parse method will be used to convert string to number like integer, float, double, long. We can convert string to integer using convert class. We'll discuss convert class in the next video. That's it for today. If you like this video, please share with your friends and subscribe to my YouTube channel for future videos. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.